Welcome to Railsware Academy. Here I present the most useful approaches and tools to help you with different aspects of product creation. And today, we'll learn how to use formatting in Google Sheets. It is easier to perceive data using visual markers, such as colors, borders, and styles. Moreover, in Google Sheets, you can use conditional formatting to apply preset styles based on the data analysis. Today, we will learn how to use conditional formatting and how to apply preset styles to multiple worksheets. I've prepared timestamps for you in the description of this video. Use those in case you want to jump right to a specific topic. Before we move to conditional formatting functionality, let's prepare a data set. To pull the data to a new sheet, I will use coupler.io extension. I select coupler in the add-ons list, open dashboard, and add an importer. Select an import from GSheets. You see that you can import from other tools as well. Paste spreadsheet link to pull data from. Run import. And here is our data set. Now, let's see how we can format based on a specific condition. Select a column to apply formatting to. Format. Conditional formatting. Here, we can see two sections, single color and color scale. Use a single color if you want to highlight cells based on a specific condition. As you see, we have negative payments stated in our data set. Those are refunds. Let's mark them red. We select the range, H2 to H. Conditional formatting automatically selects the last cell index in the range as the end of it. So even with state H2 to H, it will edit it to H2 to H17. Keep an eye on that, as if you will have more than 17 records, formatting might not be applied to all. We have a single condition here. Amount should be below zero. There are many options listed. We can format based on values, texts, and dates. You can also use custom formula. We will review this option a bit later in our video. We select is less than zero. Select the red color. And I also want the refunds to be marked bold. Click done, and here are the refunds. If you have any fixed categories, we can mark each category with a specific color. For example, we have three different subscription types: Light, Standard, and Premium. Select the column and apply conditional formatting. We can do it using right-click and choosing an option from the menu. The first rule will be the light is yellow. We specify the range, B2 to B. Now select text is exactly and state light. This function is not case sensitive. Select yellow color and here we go. Add another rule. Range that we apply formatting to is B2 to B and text is exactly standard. The color is blue. Done. And the final rule. Select the range B2 to B. Text is exactly premium. And the color is purple. And we can change the text color for it to be more readable. Let's choose light blue. Once done, we see each category marked with the correct color. If you have preset categories, it is better to combine conditional formatting with data validation. Select the same range, B2 to B, and use data, data validation. Select list of items and state three categories we have: light, standard, and premium, separated by comma. Drop-down list will appear. Now, if you select a new category from the list, the color will change automatically. Learn the advanced tricks with data validation by clicking the card above. Color scales help you identify where each value lays in the selected range. For example, we can use color scales to mark which customers have the biggest and the smallest number of users. Color scales work with numbers and dates only. Let's select the number of users column and apply conditional formatting. Select color scale and double-check the range you apply it to. We state G2 to G. Now, let's select the scale colors. There are preset styles to select from, or choose specific colors manually. I will mark the minimum values white and maximum values green. And a simple color scale appears here. You can set a midpoint to track values below and above the expected standard. Here we have a customer satisfaction score stated. Imagine that our KPI is to have a minimum of 70% satisfaction score, so everything below that should be more red and above green. I select the column, conditional formatting, color scale, check the range, then minimum value remains the same, and the color should be red. You might mismatch the percent option presented here with the percents we have in the data set. Percent in conditional formatting would calculate the 70% of the selected range. Percent in the data set is a number itself. In our case, 70% is 0.7. This is why we select number 0.7. I will mark midpoint light green as it is still within the KPI range. Finally, maximum value is marked darker green. Click Done, and here is our color scale. We often want to highlight not only one cell that contains filtered data, but the whole row having it. It is very useful in case you have many categories and columns. We can highlight the whole row based on a single condition using custom formula in G-Sheets. Let's highlight rows containing refunds. Go to Format, Conditional Formatting, Single Color. To apply conditional formatting to multiple ranges in the same worksheet, select the needed range. In our case, this will be A2 to J. If we use preset function less than 0 again, conditional formatting will scan each cell in the selected range to fit the condition and will highlight only the fitting ones. But we need to highlight the whole row if only one value fits the condition. The payment amount in this row is below 0, so we need to use a custom formula. Before we do it, in the conditional formatting panel, let's see how it works in a simple worksheet. So we need to find values in H2 to H that are below 0. We type a simple formula, equality sign, H2 is below 0. For this row, it is false. If we drag formula down, it will return true only for the values that match our condition. And conditional formatting will use this true-false logic. Go back to conditional formatting. Select A2 to J as a range to apply formatting to. Select custom formula and type equality sign H2 is below 0. We see that the spreadsheet highlighted column A only. This is because it scans all of the columns based on the next logic. A is highlighted if H matches, B would be highlighted if values in column I would match, and so on. We can avoid this issue by locking column H with the dollar sign. Now spreadsheet will scan each column, but will be looking only at the column H to match for all. As we didn't block the row number, it will change for each row. And here come our refunds. You can apply this approach to a single or multiple columns. Just switch the data range. If you want to apply the same formatting to a new worksheet, you can use the Format Painter. Let's copy current data set to a new sheet. Now, go back to our data set. Select Columns. Click the Format Painter. And go to the new sheet and select Columns to apply formatting to. Subscribe to Railsware channel and watch our next video to learn advanced tricks with custom formula. Last but not least, a great advantage of Google Sheets is that multiple people can collaborate in the same file. However, if you make changes asynchronously, how can you explain the spreadsheet structure without words? And how can you make sure that the other person doesn't break your spreadsheet? Here at Railsware, we came up with a few color coding approaches that help us avoid this. We use different colors to mark different types of data. If we have data pulled from a different worksheet or spreadsheet, mark it light blue. For example, this data set is pulled from a different spreadsheet. So let's select the columns used for data import and mark those light blue. Use dark yellow to mark cells with formulas processing data from the same worksheet, and light yellow to mark these formulas' outputs. Let's calculate price per user for each client. I first write a simple formula, equality sign H2 divided by G2. Let's make it a bit more advanced and filter out the empty cells. If the length of H2 is equal to 0, then put nothing. Otherwise, calculate H2 divided by G2. Now, to expand this calculation to the whole column, wrap it into an array formula. Watch our next videos to learn how it works. In short, array formula expands a calculation to the entire column so that you don't have to copy formula for each single row. We should convert each value to a range. So we have H2 to H and G2 to G. And you see that the formula was expanded. We mark the cell containing array formula dark yellow and the outputs light yellow. We also mark cells containing manual data light red. You can agree with your team on any other color coding schema. Remember that the key target here is to have a unified schema so that teams collaborate safely in the same files. Remember that conditional formatting significantly slows down your spreadsheet, so it's better to use it in case you want to identify the outliers or to present reports to your colleagues. Conditional formatting works great with small sets of data. However, I do not recommend you to use it on the big data sets. This was an introduction to conditional formatting in Google Sheets. In our next video, we will review more advanced custom formulas to highlight duplicates. Subscribe to Railsware channel and follow our updates. And don't forget to press like in case you like this video. Railsware is a product studio. Since 2005, we have shaped our own know-how in product creation. Railsware helped many US and EU startups to turn into multi-million dollar companies. Contact us to build your next software solution from the ground up.